single inheritance will be there. Okay, now.
Before starting, this is one row. So this is a copy construction, right? So in that one, so you did it right. So actually, there was a main class A. And after that, you copied it as A2.
That is the main constructor and copy
constructor. Okay. Like that, how many constructors you can make?
That's what, only you cannot override. See,
1 and 2.
2, that's it.
Main
and you can have one more dynamic constructor also. That's it. Again, if you try to create one more copy constructor, it is just like overriding.
Okay. So it is not in the
main.
But where that means A3 is. Means depend as an object.
A3 is depending on A1.
Yeah, but it is an object, right?
Huh.
So A2 means.
A2 is also an object of A class, but that will not be available in the main. Directly, that will be a parameter in the constructor.
Okay, but how A1
will be passed to A2.
Okay.
Okay, now that A2 values will be assigning to A and B variables. Whereas, that is a constructor of A3. So, indirectly, the values will be available to A3. Got it, right? We are storing the values from A1 to A2.
Yeah.
A2 is assigning to A3.
Yeah,
it is just like...
My question. Means how where we are assigning A1 to A2. So, that is not mentioned, right?
One second. Say, now... Here 10 and 20 we are passing to M and N.
Yes, that is okay.
In the sense, A value of A1 is, what is that, 10. How it is assigned?
Yeah, it is passing, right?
Same way, A1 I am passing to A2.
Complete A1. Okay.
Understood now?
Yeah. Okay.
A2, I am assigning to A. This A belongs to A3.
Yes.
Clear? That's it. Okay. Now we'll see single inheritance. A30 is the final result. Say, what is happening over here? Class A is there. This is the base class. What this class is doing? It has getA method, which is returning A value 10. It has getB function, which is returning B value 20. Clear? Any doubts?
No.
Now you see, here we have class B. What we are doing? Public A. That means A class features, I am making it as public. That means it is just like friendship with A. So if I am establishing public friendship, friendship with A in the sense, I can access the components of A class which is not private. If it is private, I cannot access. Okay, now he is my friend. I can speak with him. I can take his pen. I can take his book. But I cannot take his personal belonging like mobile. I cannot take his purse. Because those are private components. Correct? Now, how much ever friend it is, I cannot go till the personal level. Got it, right? That is private. If it is private, I cannot access. If it is public, protected, I can access. Is that clear? I am making friendship with class A. I will be getting the features of class A. Now, which all the features? See, A is public, B is public, get A is public. From here, everything. Get B is also public. Now, in the sum function, I am getting get A function, get B function. What is get A? 10. Get B? 20. Both I am adding and I am displaying by making use of C out. Now, which is the most derived class here? That is base class. This is derived class. Which is the most derived class? B. For that derived class only, we have to create an object. See, B, B1, B1 dot sum. So it will call this sum function. Sum function will call get A as well as get B, and it will perform the operation. Is that clear? Any doubts? That's it. This is single inheritance. Why it is single inheritance? One base class is there and one derived class is there. So it is called as single inheritance. Clear? Make a note.